Yeah, I had a check-in time.
Do you have a reservation?
Yes, sir.
And you're at the door now?
Justin Hogan.
Yep, I'll be right on out.
All right.
We've been flat out. All of the hotels have been booked out.
Deer season. That's what it is.
Deer season, and I don't know what else, but...
Show you guys. It's right here. That patch of woods right there is part of the farm I can hunt. And all that, I don't know if you can see it, backs up to the river up there. And then it goes about a mile, just a mile long and a mile wide soybean field. That patch of woods right there is pretty hot sometimes. And it's just a big bedding area. Depending on what wind I get a couple days this week, I may hunt that. This farm right here on the right side, that's where most of the deer come from. I don't know if you can see, but you can, there's crops. It's just all hardwoods. Hardwoods, cornfields, soybean field. And they keep these crops. They don't harvest them just for the sole purpose of holding the deer throughout the year. These people out here are serious deer hunters. So that's where a lot of the deer that I see come from, but they have to cross this highway to get to me. And right here is one of their main crossings. Cross out of this bottom from the right, cross the road right here. And my tree stand. Right, there's a rub right there, you can see. There's all kinds of rubs right in here. Just a main crossing, right, coming out of this holler, dropping over into this holler. My stand that I killed that deer out of last year, and the same stand that I'm going to hunt in the morning, is about 200 yards just right off this road. There's another rub back in there. Jump some does right here at the bottom of my stand. They blew. But this deer that's out in the field didn't even hear it. It's so far out there.
That's a cool buck. I had that deer on camera last year. He's searching hard. Trying to find these does. These does are bedded out in this soybean field. There's one way out there. Then there's another one right in here somewhere. I don't know what it was. I don't know if it's a doe or a buck. But it's bedded down out there. Buck just stood up out of his bed. That's the one that I seen right at the crack of daylight. I zoomed in on it with my little camera. It looks like a pretty decent buck. I don't think it's a shooter though. He's been bedded for, it's almost 10 o'clock now. He bedded down at 8 o'clock, so. He's been bedded down. Well, he just now bedded back down. Well, it's about 3:30, and it's been pretty slow the last couple hours. I've seen a lot of deer today. Seen most of the movement from like 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock. It's pretty much in the middle of the day, so. But I seen one possible shooter way across the field. I couldn't really see him that good. And there's that buck still bedded down here. I don't know. He's literally been bedded down all day. Been a pretty good day, seen a lot of deer. Still no shooters though. So
I'm back in here at least. But there's so much ground to work with. We just kind of walked down the access path, and if we would have seen somebody, we would have turned around, but I didn't see anybody on the way in here. I'm guessing they're either.
Update on how my day's going. Passed a pretty good buck this morning. Seen quite a few deer today despite the wind. I mean, it's howling. Sometime there was gusts up to 30 miles per hour. I had to just hang on to this tree. But I'm seeing these deer. They're bedding down. They're out in this field. Every so often I'll see one get up and then bed back down. But I've got a little bit of adversity to deal with here. The owner's gonna start cutting these beans tomorrow, and which sucks because the next couple days is gonna be the best 2 days as far as the weather goes. Show you, he's done pulled his stuff over there. Uh-huh. sucks because there's not really a lot of other places I can go on this farm. It's just mainly a field. There's a couple little fingers of woods over here I could maybe get in tomorrow. But it's pretty much my only option. Another thing I'm gonna show y'all. If you're like me and you buy these cheap hang-ons, this hang-on that I'm in is probably 4 or 5 years old. You always want to put a safety strap on and you always want to wear a safety harness because this right here can happen. Check this out. That is the cable that's hanging on. That's the cable to this stand. And it just broke. Thank God I put this safety strap on the other day. If you can see the strap. Here's a safety strap. Without getting wet. It's about 11 o'clock right now. And only thing I've seen this morning is those 6 doe. I feel like if there was a buck in here, he'd be after him because them does have been all over this field. And I haven't seen one buck come out and chase him or anything, so. I don't know, I'm just kind of getting discouraged. This is, let's see, what is today? Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. This is the 7th day, and I've hunted all day, every single day, and I'm just not seeing any shooters. I'm seeing a lot of deer, seeing some small bucks. Probably switch it up. I'm gonna go knock on a couple doors, get down, eat something, go knock on a couple doors, and if I can't get any permission to hunt somewhere else, I'm on. There's a piece of public ground not far from here, so I may go check that out midday. Then. Looks like we only got one guy back here. So that's good.
Got any luck?
Nope.
Are you seeing none?
Nah. Saw old doe. They're someone shooting shotguns over there. She came trotting through, but that's about it.
I ain't seen much sign. I'm just out walking around. That's the first time I've been here, so just kind of getting a feel of the area.
Yeah. Where are you from?
Kentucky.
Kentucky?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we're from Tennessee.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. Cool. All y'all are together?
Yeah.
Cool.
It's hot. It's unseasonably hot.
It sucks when it's like this, man. I hate when it's 70 degrees in November. A little bit easier walking up here, man. Back home, it's billy goat country, so.
You in East Tennessee?
East Kentucky, yeah. Yeah, so I'm kind of liking the flatland.
Yeah, we're from East Tennessee up in the mountains. So.
Yeah, so you know all about it. Yeah. Well, good luck, fellas.
Yeah, you too, man.
You too. Bed. I can smell him. He's been here today. So I more than likely bumped him out of it. So I'm going to go get on the downwind side of this field and set up. Maybe I'll see him. Maybe hunt there for the next couple days. Well, I just got settled in the stand. I got to looking around. And of course, gotta love public land.
stupid. I shouldn't even try to make the shot. It's too thick. I thought maybe I could slide an arrow through there. Fourth encounter I've had with that buck. That deer has drove me crazy. I mean, I tried to squeeze an arrow through a bunch of brush. I could see he was broadside, and it's getting dark. And I thought I had a pretty good hole. Shot, I just seen the arrow just shoot straight in there.
Me.
He's done, baby. Smoked. Smoked. Oh, baby.
doe.
Oh. I prayed so much. Oh, I've worked my tail off. Yes! Yes! Oh, thank you, Lord. Oh my God. Smoked him. Nice 8-point. Me. I can't believe it. He said under me. I was grunting. And I heard him back there rubbing a tree or something. And I caught a glimpse of him going the opposite direction. He's going away from me. I started grunting at him again. He couldn't take it no more. He turned and come up here. I could have catched my breath. I'm tore all to pieces. I don't even know what to say. There's the arrow. Complete pass through, stuck in the ground. Grim Reaper, baby. There he is. Dandy 8. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. He's got some pretty tall tines. I'm tickled to death with him. He's it's been a tough year up here in Ohio for me. I've hunted like 18 days straight, hunted all day. I hunted here a week, didn't have any luck, so I went and tried some public land out, and actually got on the big one there. Had an encounter with him 4 times. I ended up missing him like 2 days ago, and I've just been frustrated. It just wore me out. I'm tired. I'm very thankful. I mean, again, all the glory goes to God. He sent me this deer. I felt like he knew I've been having a hard time, so I guess he was like, I guess enough's enough, and he finally sent me a dandy. And I can't be more tickled to death with him. He's got some kind of knot right here on the back of his neck. Just a humongous body deer. I mean, just he's black looking too. I never killed a deer that's just almost solid black like he is. If you haven't subscribed, please do give me a like. That way it gives you a notification whenever I post the videos. And yeah, that's it. I just want to thank all y'all and see you on the next video.